So, you thought I was a bit weird to go on the floor and do all these new things. I learned this week, actually. I learned a lot of new things. Pulling of the leg. Have you seen the slap? Looking for the audience. Which one I can... definitely this one with the trousers up, you know, show the legs. Of course, for me, it is something to do with excitement of a dancer wanting to communicate. All these mannerisms, making the audience react to you, making them silent. It all has a meaning. But it's funny when it becomes out of context and that you see a dancer doing it automatically every time at the same place without even referring to what he is doing or she is doing. So for me, it was a very amusing experience to judge the earlier rounds because some of the younger couples or the couples in the middle of the field, they were doing all these mannerisms on autopilot. It just made no sense. And for me, it was at some points hilarious, sometimes frustrating because they were more busy, what I call about the YouTube phenomenon, that you see everything on YouTube and then you just copy what you see on this two-dimensional screen. My lecture is not gonna be about this. I have no special tricks for you to notice in the comp, which is of a certain value for a judge. No special tricks, but basically I'm gonna talk about, I got the task from WDSF, poise, coordination, the first criteria and balance. And that is what I'm gonna talk about, and I'm gonna try my very best to make it related to judging. Because I'm usually teaching, and there's a different method. So I'm trying a little bit today to activate you to make a decision, to ask yourself, how do you recognize these qualities? And therefore, I will give you, of course, my points, but more interesting, how to recognize. Because if I only show you the teaching method, it's not of your interest, really, as a judge. It could be of interest as a teacher, but really your interest is how to recognize when somebody has been taught in a very nice manner. And you can see that actually things are being done in according to this institution's values and style. So I'm gonna go through today three dances, the principles of coordination and how to detect it, the quality of the coordination, the balance, the posture. I'm gonna go through some relation to choreography. I know this is not my task, but I have to talk about it because I think choreography or the construction of how you make the choreography either supports the values of coordination or it doesn't. So sometimes I see choreography which goes away from actually what we are doing. And it's been going quite extreme. And in the competition, I found myself being a little bit frustrated, looking at a good couple, waiting for them to show me something that resembled a certain dance. It was a cha-cha or was it a samba? But they did nothing of that. They just did special mannerisms, special self-invented steps, which are fine, but we have a certain style and we are building the way we dance upon those basic actions. And if we don't recognize them as a judge, how can we evaluate it? I would put it a bit extreme. Can you imagine a ballet competition? I'm pretty sure in Russia there's a lot of those, at least in America. There's a lot of specialists sitting evaluating ballet dancers from a very clear criteria, aesthetic, how they are centered in the specific style of ballet. And if some dancer comes in and goes out of line with the modern dance, which is not referred to as the technique of the ballet, I'm pretty sure they would not recognize it as fantastic. because that is not what they are asked to do. So you could say we do some fashionable steps, we do some Michael Jackson stuff, we do some hip-hop moves. It's all fine if it stays with the character, if we still can recognize that this is a cha-cha that has been developed and we come back to the base all the time. I think that for me is very important. So my first point here today is choreography that supports the character of the dance, the action which is used, Cuban motion, let's take the cha-cha-cha, partnering, to be together with a partner. If it continues the way it does now, in 5 years, we have no touching. It will be solo work from start to finish. Because what? It's so easy. It's so easy for me to dance alone. The difficult part, I spent 20 years of my life to develop and understand my ability as a partner and to become the greatest partner I could possibly be for Christina and to show that for the audience. And now I could have might as well just ignored that difficult task, and I would say that is the most difficult task in our institution. So if I see a couple who chooses to ignore the fact that it is a partner valued dance, I have to put that in perspective to how they are producing the product. So if I have a couple, I can really see that they have the skills, they can communicate, they do a fantastic action together, there's a communication between the coordinations of the body. I'm not talking about partner skill today, I'm talking about coordination. If I see that happening, I have to credit that, I have to give it credit. If I see somebody who is on their own, just ignoring each other, I become bored. It's not what I'm there for. It's not Latin American dancing. And I think that's a very, very strong point for me to say to you about my opinion. And that's why probably sometimes people see that I judge, maybe not the form, but I want to judge and honor the couples who are trying to develop that difficult skill. I don't say that other couples are not talented or great and fantastic. I'm just saying they do less difficult stuff. And I have to honor the complexity and the difficulty of two human beings dancing and communicating. So that was the first point related to coordination. Today I'm going to ask you to be active at one point. It's a little bit a test for myself. I don't know if it's going to work. But very often you sit and listen to us lecturers. But actually I want to get your hands down and dirty and work and think for yourself. Make a decision. So I have asked today 6 couples to assist us in this lecture, and at one point I would like you to evaluate for yourself a specific criteria in rumba and make a decision for yourself, the order of the dancers, how are they being placed for you in that specific quality, not overall but a specific quality. And then I would like you to discuss with your neighbor, just point of opinion. We're going to start off with cha-cha-cha, and I think it's very important for me in the cha-cha-cha to recognize and see that there is a center which is alive, a center which is alive. And I see that basically from the back or from the mid area, the torso, that I can see a dancer which is fluently coordinating all the cha-cha action from the center. So I basically feel that the cha-cha is done and centered around this area quite a lot, and it's initiated from this area. So that means the step is a result of how I time my body. And what I often see in competition, if I can just use you, Christina, just for a second. It helps to have you. We're going to do Cuban breaks, and we're going to do the actuality of step. So we're going to see the step. 2, 3, 4, 1. 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. Okay? So I see the step. I can do it even better. Really full power. Super slick. Ready? And two. Okay, so I'm really excited about this. I'm giving it a full blast. Of course, we are making a little bit of joke out of it. There's nuance. This is not as bad for many couples. What we would like to see is that the step is happening all the time from a body initiation. So basically, what we do is we're gonna charge the body, and the step is happening isolated from my weight chains. So what you actually can see is that the couple is moving to the step, so the body becomes one-dimensional. And we are not concerned about that. What we're concerned about is how to create rotation and wind up in the body. So there's a coordination of the top body which decides the leg. And when I do that, great, I can make decision. I have no chance in the other one. It would be the same in every round. Two and three. I would do the same. I'm stuck. And then, of course, it's a production on top. But most important is that we have a difference between foot timing. So there's a clarity of foot. And then there's also a clarity of hip. Because we could also do it quite, let's say, out of character of cha-cha if we do it all the time like this. You know, suddenly now the body is overdoing the action. So we are not measuring the action of the body to what step I'm doing. So it has to be in relation to the step. And how you recognize that is to see that it is perfectly related to the music. You see that there's a vibration inside the body, and you can see that there is no effort in that. The outside of the body is quite free, and it becomes very powerful from the center. I'm going to try again. Good. So I'm putting force into the center, and it's not a hard work. There's no tension on the outside. I'm just activating my center to create that. Of course, we need to go through the setup of the body to do this, how to recognize the body. When we see a misunderstood hip action, where the dancer is showing me the hip as an actuality, is none of my interest. The hip is a different function for us. The hip area is a supporting area. That means we are supporting from here, we are working in the middle area, and we are framing the top. So we create, you can say, an organic feel from the legs, which is a chain of muscle through the body. It's supported to the hip bone, and in the center area, it is free and fluid because I'm supported from the base. On top of that, I have the style, which our institution also want to recognize, a bit from the European feel of balletic idea. It's not only Cuban. We don't collapse everything and just get in here. We have to have a certain style. So the framing, if we do it very slowly, I'm supporting from the base, and then I have a freedom of the center, and then there is a discipline and a connection to a frame on the top. And so there is a certain discipline, and then everything becomes more three-dimensional, and it becomes more, you can say, it looks easy. But it still has an edge, still has an activity. We want to show you later with the couples in music how this is done. So we have the muscle chain. So if we see a dancer which is collapsed, I'm looking at the back, I'm looking from here, and I can see that the body is collapsed on top of the leg, and you can see it's not alive. That is a less value. And you can say the really, really best dancers have found that activity inside themselves, and then they start to make artistic choices inside it. So I'm not giving you here a rule that this is how it's supposed to be or how it should be. I'm giving you a scale to how to recognize How good is this achieved? How well is this dancer achieving this skill? When we have the muscle chain and this life inside, we actually get much more musicality. So that's on a different evaluation. So on this, you can say posture is to make sure that you give freedom. And I want to see a dancer that actually is going against gravity in some point, but going into gravity in another point. And that combination is difficult. So we have all heard about boned action, to dance the cha-cha on the leg and make it very strong and down. I don't disagree with that, but I would say there's an opposite force going in the other way. So when I bone myself, but I'm elevated. I still have a feeling that there's an, I'm not collapsing, I'm not going one way. Nothing goes the same way. So the complex dancer, the developed dancer, is one who has developed the skill of opposition and understanding that this is a three-dimensional. Nothing goes the same way, or not everything. There's always something going against. About the character of the cha-cha, very, very easy to recognize. There's a walk and there's a step. A walk is how long time? How long is a walk? Very quiet. One beat. One beat. Super. If you take your time, it could be more. But normally, basically, it's one beat. A step is, super, Jürgen, you got it. Step is half a beat. I will try to make a relation to quick step. Quick step, there's a slow and a quick. There's a huge difference if I do a slow and I do a quick. The whole technique, the whole activity, the whole, you can totally recognize, aha, that's a slow and that's a quick. In action, I'm not talking about time value, I'm talking about action. In cha-cha, I see no difference. I see dancers who are not achieving the clarity of difference between a slow and a quick. Therefore, a full action is one we have a body action, a pendulum, a rotation, and it's full, it's delicious, it's challenged, I have the time to do it, and therefore I choose to do it. If I have a cha-cha action or a quick, I'm much more lifted and much more direct, and it's a total different sensation in the body. And there we see couples who are two and three and cha-cha, that everything actually goes together. So they are not mastering the clarity of that coordination, because that gives a better musical interpretation. And then it starts to look like cha-cha. What we create is dancers who have speed and continuation and fullness at the same time. That's what we want. So I'm just going to show you. Two and three. Zik-tik-boom. It's very clear I make a choice. Zik-tik. Nothing. Yeah? And how often do we see that they just power on? You know, everything is killed to a degree that there is no sense of music inside it. It can only go one way. It can go more than last time. I can put a little bit more effort, but the couple will be running a bit ahead of time, or at least just on time, but there is no magic inside it. So, what is it I do? I have a body pendulum rotation. I'm full in the action. When I choose now to do a step, I'm split weight. I'm stepping. Zip. There's nothing. I'm split weight. I'm not transporting weight to my leg. Because if I do, my body will continue because of the momentum, and the next step will be very poor. It will be ruining the activity for the next slow. So how often do we see a dancer going cha-cha-cha-cha? It's like falling ahead, and therefore they lose the speed and the clarity of the cha-cha, which is a quick. So we're going to show again. 2 and 3. Zik, chick, boom. So it's like tick, tick. It's very, very chosen to be specific. The hip, you can see, as a judge, you just see if the hip is still moving free in this activity. Zip, boom. Tick, boom. Too much? No definition. No cha-cha, just a flow through. Everybody can do it. I wriggle my hip, and it has no value. It's just a shell trying to show a hip action which is not understood. For me as a judge, it's very easy to link into that thing, because as you see with all the mannerisms and all the activity, it's very, very easy to be overpowered by this show. And for me as a judge, I have to then, okay, I stick to this. I actually go to this area from the chest to the knee, and I just focus on how is it functioning. And it's very, very easy to detect if the dancer is capable of doing what they're supposed to do. And you can also evaluate it quite quickly. Aha, it is mastery. Next, this one is struggling. But we're trying to be busy. It's a little bit like waving the hand. Don't look at my foot. Yeah. So that would be a good suggestion. Now I want to show you a choreography. We're going to show you very slowly all the dances together. That is also in reference to that the choreography supports this style of cha-cha-cha. That we have a full beat, we have a quick beat, and it's very clear to detect. So I'm very happy that some couples have agreed to help me today. We will dance together with them. So when you get bored of the old ones, you look at the young and fresh ones. That should be okay. So in the cha-cha, I would like to welcome Malte and Sandra from Denmark, Val and Alina from Russia, Igor and Sofie from Denmark, let me see, Rasmus and Line from Denmark, Pierre and Marianne from France, and my lovely wife, Christina. So what we're going to do now is just show you very slowly. And now I would like you to relate to what I've spoken about in order to detect the clarity of the quality of a full beat, a half beat. How is it connected through the center? How is it actually achieved to become a nice coordination in relation to poise and everything which to do with poise, balance and coordination? Okay, very slow. 2, 3, and 4, and 1. 2, 3, 4, 1. 2, 3, 4, and 1. 2, 3, 4, and 1. 2, 3, 4, and 1. 2, 3, 4, 1. 2, 3, 4, and 1. 2, 3, 4, 1. 2, 3, 4, and 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 1. 2, 3, and 4, and 1. And 2, 3, 4, and 1. 2, 3, 4, 1. 2, 3, and 4, and 1. 2 and 3, 4, 1. One note, there's a specific step which we call rotational slip chassis. I don't know if it exists. Somebody call it something else. It's not in the technique book. It could either be a development of a slip chassis, which is on one line, or it could be a development of the time step, syncopated. You decide. It looks like this. And cha cha cha, and cha cha cha. We see a lot of this. We call it a rotational slip chassis because we want to actually move a bit of weight to slip this foot under in order to collect the weight under ourselves again. So very often when we see this step, it gets blocked. Hammer it back, Can you recognize it? So there's like a zakata, zakata. And I miss inside that cha-a. There's a reaction in a cha-cha. And are we ready? Are we dancing it? All right. Two, three, and cha. 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 Very specific. Foot, hip reaction. Foot, hip reaction. And then a full beat. Some of you argue that's not possible. I would doubt, I would dare you that it is. If you do it totally right. If you do it totally a little bit off, it ruins everything. It's a killer. Bloody hell, Peter is teaching some weird stuff. So, we'll just do it one more time. Two, three, and cha, 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 and 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 cha, thank you very much. We would like to show you with slow music this. Try to look at the couples to recognize this quality, specifically about coordination. They're all wonderful and they're great. I was always told there's no slippery floor, there's just bad balance. But it was of course an amusement, or actually nearly like a horror movie, to see the first round in ballroom. It was like those puppets, you know, and the Tivoli. Bong, there's one. Pretty dangerous. And I said to myself, well, it's just because they're overpowering, they don't get their balance right. And then I fall on my butt. Let's do it one more time. Normal speed. So, a big point of this is, don't go for the style or the individual choice. Of course, that's also a value, that you like it. It's appealing. But what you have to go for is every couple here is different. Hopefully they don't do it the same way. There's a little personal difference that make this step special for that human being. And I think this is what makes dancing magical. We are not put in a box. It's not rules, and it has to be like this, otherwise you're dead. Yes? And the funny thing is that I'm saying this, I was in a box for 10 years. I loved being in there, it was wonderful. People didn't understand me. I came out of the box, it was quite nice. The box, not the closet. So, anyway, the point is, there's a level of understanding. It takes years to understand this, to perfect it like a pianist, like a musician, a jazz musician. The best ones are the oldest ones. They've done it so long that it becomes mastery. And there's no quick fix to that. And for the dancers who really last and become masters of our institution, are the ones who have this setup of mind, who really wants to develop themselves, to constantly question themselves. So therefore, I would like you to honor that when you see a couple who is, you can see they're on their way, they have the right idea, the concept, haven't gotten it quite yet, and then there's other couples who can see they don't give a damn. And I really want to say that it's, of course, frustrating for me to see that couples just think that it's easy. It's bloody difficult, and it takes a lot of years. That was my message in Cha-Cha-Cha, and I want to continue with Samba, trying to keep it from a judge's point of view. Oh, I'm losing my voice. I should have gone out drinking yesterday. My voice would be perfect. So, Samba, poise, balance, coordination. I have one point. It is how to detect a sense of Samba in everything. A sense of Samba. There is a bounce in everything. It's maybe not so visible. So I know bounce is described in the technique book as an actuality. Bending and straightening the knees, it says. So why is a lockstep on total straight knees, block body, it has no sense of Samba at all. Just running forward, full blast, going through here, no sense of Samba. So very easy to detect. Is there a sense of bounce in a step, any step? Lockstep, promenade run, all the special steps they have, which are not described, there is a bounce. And I want to be very specific what I mean by that. It means that if I do a lockstep in cha-cha, cha, 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 it's straight knee, it is simply the same technique as in Samba, but there's a difference. Samba is cha, cha, cha. There's a sense of breathing, there's a sense of zik-tik-wak. There's a sense of continuation, a play with the sound. It's a full sound. It's something which is joyful. It's a different character. It's not as precise and measured as cha-cha. So of course, it has to look like Samba. And I'm not impressed when I see this zigzag. And it's a race car coming from down here. And they go, let's see if I can hit the wall. And the end, hopefully there's somebody to stop me. And simply, the priority is, can we do it a bit stronger next time? Just a bit harder. Hit it! I'm getting nervous. I'm getting really, actually, I feel for the girl. Because she's the one that has to turn and rip her arm off. And there's no, there's also a sense of Samba in this. And there's nothing. Thank you. And I say, I like speed, I like power, if it's done with mastery. And I would argue that the best dancers in the world, they are much more powerful the ones that are just powerful. It looks much more. So it's a mistake, it's a misunderstanding of the concept that just to solve it with power, let's do a little bit more muscle. How about using some technique to understand how it's done? Not the right way, but the best way. Somebody knows a guy called Sergei Bubka. Pole something. He goes in the air. He's a little guy from Russia. Is he? No, not Russia. Yes. He's retired. He did the pole jumping, you know? He was not very tall, but he had a better technique. So he developed the technique, and I had a feeling that he could jump higher. He knew exactly what he needed to do. He didn't tell anybody. So he asked all the organizers, listen, I'm going to break the world record this time. How much would you pay me if I do it? And he just jumped 1 meter higher. Maybe he could jump 5 meters higher, but nobody was near him. That's a pretty good deal, isn't it? Let me see today, I'm going to jump 1 meter high, 1 centimeter higher, because I know exactly I can do much more. I'm not showing the world. That's a powerful thing. He jumped higher because of one thing, technique. Of course, physics, you have to have it. But what makes the difference in the pole jumping is the complexity of the jump. It is so difficult to time, and therefore he was mastering that. He was the best. So, recognizing the bounce in the back, from the back. Can I have the samba people on the floor? I can't remember who's doing what. My wife is you also, Christina. You're not being let off. Let's all turn the back to the audience. And let's do a whisk starting with the right foot. And have a look at how the back is dancing, that there's a continuity in the lower part. Hopefully there's no destruction in the top part. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1 and 2. 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 Thank you. We want to have speed. We want to have rhythm, continuity. And the trick is to combine it. So we are very, very clear. When you see a dancer who can do a whisk on the highest level, they are totally timing and preparing this quarter beat, very specific. But it's invisible. You don't see it in the body. Zook, whoop, zoom. And then the continuation is after. So there's a separation. The foot arrives, and then I make the life. We are not doing the hip together with the foot, 1 and 2. What can I do? Finished. So let's try that. Just stop on the 7, 8. 1 and 2. 1 and 2. 1 and 2. Thank you. It's not, yes, thank you. It is, of course, a quarter beat. But quarter beat does not mean that you have to arrive on the foot and be on the other foot next at 1/4. It doesn't mean in waltz that you have to be on the foot and the next one. You're on the way. The foot is placed. Zip. The next foot is placed. I haven't left the other one. So I do a couple and people think that I'm leaving the back foot in a quarter. I'm not. Zicka, whoop. I'm delivering to the front foot. It's much longer time. But the front foot is arriving and it's not moving, so therefore it's invisible. So therefore you don't see it. And we have couples. 1 and then this and then that, you know. Quarter beat, finish. Continuation. Zicka, whoop-a. It's the life in between that makes it magic. It's very clear. We have done a choreography. Again, there's no bounce in it. No whisk, no voltas, no nothing of bounce, but we want to bounce. We want to sense samba in it. So we'd like to show you this. All three of us, very slow. I think we are four couples. Go a bit back. I'll try with one hand. 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1. Skal vi fortsætte? Nej. Thank you. As you can see here, there is no bounce, classical bounce movement. But we want to make it samba as well. Just a little idea. I see merengue runs. Funny merengue runs. Merengue runs that runs everything the same way. I'm going. Where are you going? Have you left the building? It's too easy to go on your toes and just go through the legs. This is not merengue. Somebody who knows merengue knows that there's a body sense and there's a opposition in the body that creates merengue. So you don't just hop around with feet like this. Yeah? I do a merengue run action. It's full of body. It's merengue. I don't just go. I could, but I choose not to because I'm doing samba. Do you recognize it? Yes? It's so easy to detect when it's done with a sense of music. I can be a musical dancer, but ignore the technique or the characteristic of this dance. So now we would like to show you very slowly with music one time, and hopefully we go full on, and then I need a break. Ready, couples? Let's do it full on. Still have a look at these qualities to have see if there's a sense of music, a samba feel, a samba bounce in the actions we're doing. If we block it, if we stop, and there's not a sense of life inside, it's either a choice or it's that I'm not able. But if you choose it all the time, you're probably not able. Yes? I'm going to talk about rumba, and we're going to try to give you a clear reference point how to detect quality of coordination and posture and balance in a rumba. It's for me the most deep dance. It's very, very emotional, but in order to become emotional about it, I have to feel it. I have to be a felt sensation of movement. it's not an exterior production of mannerisms where I'm not buying it. You have done it a million times, now you do it again, and it's like a conveyor belt of doing it. And I'm getting bored as a judge. Now we're talking the highest level. We are talking about really the top of the amateurs in the world, what we see in the WDSF and the professional division, that it is a mastery of movement that creates emotion and it becomes believable. I can feel it as an audience, as a judge. But of course, we need to be able to detect it in the earlier rounds on a different level, you could say. Because that's really easy to make a difference between the one who is in the 24 and the one who is not. Very clearly, the rumba takes a lot of power and strength from the feet, from the leg. Everything has to be done with a sense of control and awareness of body weight. Where is my body weight? How is it changing? And how do I distribute it to become like a Rolls Royce, a fluent, full, fat movement with a very, very clear foot timing? This is the magic. It's very easy to make everything full. It's very easy to let everything go and become full. It's also very easy to be very clear. You know, everything is defined with feet. And the magic is to understand and to recognize as a judge the dancer who has achieved the sensation of body change, foot timing, and fullness inside it. So there's a life between the actuality of feet. And then, of course, there's a very, very clear cube in motion, which is constructed in a very certain way. Pendulum, rotate. Not pendulum tilt. Pendulum tilt is not existing. Well, you can choose to do it, but what happens is I block my whole body. It's gone. So if I want to create an opposition, it has to be done from internally. It's not an outside showing the world. So the cube in motion is felt internally. I'm not showing you. I can do it pretty good. But really, I don't get it. The exterior is a result of the internal. Of course, I'm aware of my outside, but I feel the motion and the action very, very close to my center. And then it becomes, you can feel it's like I'm full of it. I'm not letting it go. And I want to talk about cucaracha for you. Let's see if we can recognize it. Again, in the rumba, very clear to detect it in this area. Is hips going by themselves? Are they disconnected from the top of the body? Or is it connected all the way through? So you see a current running. So when I dance my pendulum and rotation, you can clearly see that there's a reaction in my upper body. It's not decoration, it's a reaction. It happens because I'm doing it internally. It's very important to recognize that. There's so many who produce on the top. You know, there is a sense of showing, and then the engine is running different on a different car. It's like two different cars going. Yeah, one is red and one is blue. Maybe put it together and then we'll have a much better idea. I would like to use the, how many? Three couples in rumba. Christina? We're going to do opening out. So, just slowly. Four and one, two and three, four one, two and three, four one, two and three, four one. Just continue. Two and three, four one, two, and three, and stop. Okay, that was pretty crappy with the microphone. So I will just explain to you with the microphone first. The man is celebrating the standing foot. He's not going anywhere. I'm celebrating here. I'm placing this foot. It is a flat in the end, but when I place it, it's an inside ball of foot. I'm not going flat because I don't have the activity and chain of action to receive me. So I go and zip. It's like a zip, and then everything continues fluently. And that definition again, foot leg definition and body action, two separate things, but related, understood and found. Zik. And you can see my body is exploring rotation. It's preparing this way, but I'm staying here. I'm not going. Very often we see this. You know, everybody goes out of frame to create an effect. Now it's lost. So I'm losing the reference point of center. Zik, chik, vroom, zoom. It's full, it's continuous, it's musical. The girl is doing a delayed forward walk. The man is delaying her. And if this is done with a lot of skill, you can see the volume between the bodies playing. So when she delays, the man is here, he delays her, and you can see the opposition, and then she switches. So the next one is very full, and the girl is keeping her bum under herself. She is doing this, she supports her leg action from the base, she dances a hip, she's not letting go of the hip. Now it's just decoration, it's legs and top. Yeah, connect through the center. Zook, zook, zoom, delay, zoom, boom. It's very supported from the base. Let's try without a microphone. Two, three, four, and one. Zoom. Thank you. Huge thing I haven't mentioned, which is not in the criteria of what I've been describing today, is connection. Two human beings connecting through a physical point. How is that analyzed? How is that seen as a judge? How can we detect it? I think it's very, very easy to see when there is a current running between the two people. You can see it if you look at them as a total, you just look at it. Is it going together? Is it speaking together? Or are they just doing it? No, so sometimes I look not directly at it, but a little bit in the peripheral side, and I can feel and sense if they are speaking. And very often you can see it in the girl that she's fuller in action. She looks much more with a great partner. It looks huge. She looks full of sensuality and continuation and sexy and everything. By themselves, okay, they can look sexy. It's good, but with the support of connection, it is something magical. And that's why we do it. So we have done a choreography, of course, touching each other. Very obvious. I'm not against side by side. I'm not saying that. I say it has to have its place. It has to have a meaning, because I can communicate without physical touch. So I'm not here to say to you that everything that is not touching is bad. I'm just saying to have a look at it. Maybe, I would say if you look at a couple for 10 seconds, at one point there should be something going on. And I have seen couples dancing 30 seconds alone, 25, 30 seconds, not touching at all. I think it's really not it. Why not 1 minute then? We might as well do that. It's no problem. So where's the limit? What is reasonable in a partner dance? I'm just putting the question because we are judges and we have to make an idea about this if we want to accept that it just goes on more and more individual work, or we actually see the couples who are producing something together that they actually get a benefit or they're being honored. So let's do the choreography. We have done quite simple, developed basic action. Basic action, whoops, sorry. 2, 3, 4, 1. Syncopated open hip twist, 3 and 4. Wobbature timing to fan, 2 and 3, 4, 1. Lady closes, 2, 3, 2, a la manna, 4, 1. We make a little special feature, 2 and 4. Yes, sorry, and 4. Then now we're doing opening out, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. Spiral turn, the lady turns a spot turn, 2, the man stretches up, runs past her, 3 and 4, turns her, she overturns, 2 and 3, 4, 1, he goes to her, 2. Quite basic, quite simple, but it's a nice feel of relationship. We would like to do that with slow music. Slow music, rumba is slow. Anything, we'll see. Very slow. Lots of crazy things. Two people fall asleep in love. Not always change with time. The future none can see. The road you leave behind. Ahead lies mystery. Okay, so a fullness inside the individual body and a fullness in the couple between them. We have an idea that this point in the middle is the most quiet place on earth. It is so quiet that you will not detect it. You will not see me doing stuff. Hopefully you will see her action. It's like a hurricane. The middle point is totally dead silent. Therefore, we match each other. So everything which goes to and away in my own area is related to a common point, which is, of course, changing all the time. It's not static. It's not the same distance. It could be closer. It could be away. It's all related to the two human bodies moving. But the thing is, there is a connection from my frame, which you spoke about in the beginning. There's a connection through to my arm, and this hand is quite free. I'm flexible in the hip, in the shoulder, in the shoulder joint, and I would say I forgive, because I must say this is for me a very misunderstood idea that the man is leading. You know, I'm leading her. Boom, boom. Okay. So the point is, there is a life. I respect the lady. She's answering back. I say to her something. She answers back, and there's always a respect about this middle point. And we use this connection to assist, help, and apply a little extra tension, speed, when we do physical lead. But it's very, very limited. It's very, very short. It's at the right time. Now I turn her, zip, and then there's nothing again. It looks very powerful on the outside, but there's no force on these arms. We often see actuality. I can see this going around, producing that, and actually the guy is steering a truck, sometimes a small little nice car, but sometimes a truck, and it looks like it's overproduced. It's a sense here. Yes, you answer. I answer back. There's a communication, and it's so full of individuality that it makes it interesting. So the point of connection is I connect to myself, and if I'm connected to me in my hand, I'm connected. End of story. I'm not connecting to her. It's a wrong idea. It goes away from me. My connection. Now she will feel what I'm doing. Totally. I trust that she will feel it. And if she doesn't, it's her problem. Really, it's about me. I sense, I do, I give something here, make sure that she can feel me through my own frame. I'm not concerned how she answers. I love when she answers, and I answer back, super. But I'm not controlling it. I'm not in charge of what she answers. I think that's magical. That's on the highest level when you have achieved this activity. Anyway, have a look at the fullness, the strength from the base, that there's an activity in the torso and a clear timing of feet and a clear coordination of the spine and hip area. We're going to do it one more time. Now it's your turn, not to dance, but to be activated. I would like now the six couples to come to the floor. They're going to perform their individual routines. You are going to assess and evaluate coordination from these criteria, which I spoke about today. And you're just going to have your own idea. It's not like a big production. Just give a little analyzation of this. When we finish the rumba, I would like you to give 2-3 minutes to speak to your neighbor. How you perceive this? What was your order, and why? I would like the couples to step back again. No, not now. After you step back, so they can speak about you privately, not with everybody, just with your person next to you. Seriously, don't point fingers. Well, you can. It's okay now. You accepted. Okay, let's try. Give them a hand. Thank you, couples. Please step back. And I would like everybody to discuss with a neighbor. Hopefully you are not alone. So turn around to your neighbor and explain what you thought. One criteria: coordination, poise, and balance of these criteria. You're going to get a few minutes. Sounds like you finished. Wonderful. We are not gonna make any winners or any statement on this. It was just an exercise for you to discuss with somebody and share opinion. And really, I'm really happy that you guys wanted to take the challenge. It's very daunting, I know, to be in front of all these judges who will see you. So I think we should give them a big round of applause. Come forward. We have gone through three dances. I have given you my view on how to recognize quality in poise, balance, and coordination. Very much on coordination. Poise and balance is part of it, a little bit, maybe. I'm not sure. But coordination is a big thing, and I think that it's very easy to recognize this if we look for it. It can be difficult because it's so busy. There's a lot of noise, there's a lot of energy, and then there's a couple. I tend to go for the little quiet couple. I have a weakness for that. Maybe not so expressive, but I can see they are trying and they are really, and they do it and they feel it, and I have to honor that. That doesn't mean I don't like speed and power. I like a couple who is very powerful, who has achieved this skill. This is absolutely the goal. But if I had to choose between a couple who is trying and really connect and coordinate and a couple who has chosen to create the effect, I would always go for the quality or the coordination. Thank you. Another big point today, just to recap, choreography can either kill a couple or support them. I need to see choreography that resembles what we are doing. What is the institution's values? What is our techniques? What is the base action? It's becoming silly to see couples who just dance by themselves for endless time, not concerned about a partner whatsoever. Huge production individually, wonderful, super charged, super convincing in themselves, but really doesn't do it for me. So I think that's a big thing, because often we don't have time to analyze how is this choreographically going, you know. I'm not talking about the choreography, what they choose to do, but the idea. Ah, there's an idea here, they do this, that makes meaning, it does make sense to me, two human beings dancing together. If it doesn't, then all these mannerisms are all wonderful. Ears and whispering and slapping the thigh is good, it's wonderful, if it gives me a meaning. If everybody does it just on autopilot, it's actually hilarious. It's funny to watch. So, this was the idea. You have been wonderful. You haven't slept, some of you maybe, I don't know. But I tried my best to keep you activated. I would like to finish off, because Christine and I are not, we haven't had so much time since we opened a studio in Denmark, so we haven't had so much time to do performances and dancing, so I'm a little deprived from that. I need to dance. And I would like to dance with Christina just one last time in rumba, if you don't mind. Thank you very much. It's been a great honor to be invited here by the WDSF, and I took this task very serious, as I do with everything that's to do with dancing. It was nice. So thank you very much. It's been a pleasure. I will leave it here. Thank you.